And that should hopefully be it. Hopefully I've got everything right this time. You would not believe how hard it is to set this stuff up for the first time. Well, it's not the first time anymore. It was the first time an hour ago. Okay. On topic. Sorry it's taken me so long to get everything set up and posted. I know I said that I would start posting videos and stuff, like, probably a month ago at this point. But everything got a bit away from me. I've been very busy lately. And also, I've had to teach myself how to do all this stuff, because I don't have a video crew. So it really is just me here. But I got my stuff. I got my lighting. I got my microphone. I have my webcam. And hopefully I have you listening to me, and I'm not recording this for nothing. So, I've got all this set up to tell you today about the Giant Shrek Doll. This is one of my favorite stories, and I wanted to tell this story first for a reason. It would have been about... Oh, it would have been 2004? It must have been 2004, because the election was on and Bush was getting reelected, and we're not here to talk about Bush getting reelected. It's not that kind of channel. But I was in New York at the time. I would have been 14, and it was me and my mom. And we were a big fan of DVD games. I don't know if any of you remember them. They came and went so fast. There were these games where you put a disc in your DVD player, and then it sort of let you play a trivia game. It used the software, and it was cool at the time, but then we realized we all just had video game consoles and computers, and we just went back to using those instead. But for a time there, they were a big freaking deal. And Mom and me were huge fans, because we love movie trivia, and trivia in general. So, we're in New York, and we're at the Toys R Us there, which had a Ferris wheel in it, and we wanted to get some DVD games, because back in Australia, you could only get like one or two, but they had a whole section of them over at that Toys R Us. So Mom and I got, oh god, probably 6 or 7 different ones. And spent a good chunk of change on them, too. And we went to go check out. And the checkout chick, or whatever, we're not calling them that these days, probably. The checkout specialist, she was not a specialist. She was new, bless her. And she bungled up the transaction somehow. And then she went to fix it. And then she messed it up again. And we're patient, we're nice about it, but it's getting to be a while, and eventually she has to call the manager over, and he has to sort out everything that she has wrought, and eventually finally gets it sorted out. And he says, we're very sorry about this, this is not the Toys R Us experience, which I'm sure it's not, everyone has a bad day. And we're very sorry about this, and as a token of our, how sorry we all are, you, can choose a stuffed animal. We have a promotion on right now where if you spend over a certain rather large amount, your child gets the choice of either a giant stuffed Shrek or a giant stuffed donkey. The donkey from Shrek, not just any donkey. Shrek donkey. And they're huge. Like, huge. Like, the kind of stuffed animal that kids dream about. Huge. And, you didn't spend enough to get one of these, but, because we're all so sorry, you can pick one of them. And I look over at my mom, and she looks at me like, don't put this on me, it's your choice. I guess rank has its privilege. And I look over them, and they are just the god ugliest things I've ever seen in all my life. I mean, they were show accurate. They weren't, you know, messed up or nothing, but I'm sorry. I liked the Shrek movies, but Shrek and Donkey are not cute. I don't want to hug either of them. They're cool. I like the movie, you know, somebody want, love that stuff. No. I just sort of sit there like, cause I don't know. I don't want either of them. And I end up picking Shrek because I figure he's the star of the movie, so he's probably worth more or something. So we leave in a daze, Mom and me. She with her arms full of DVD games, me with my arms full of Shrek. And we go back to the hotel with our loot, and we dump it all out, and we put the giant Shrek doll on the couch, which was against the wall across the hotel from me, right in front of my bed. And there he sits for the rest of our week-long trip. And every morning I wake up and he's there. And we just look at each other like, what are we gonna do? We can't take this guy home. He's so huge, we need to buy like a whole extra luggage just to fit his whole bulk in there. And, you know, then we'd have to pay for that. And we don't want him, but we can't, like, what do you do when you have a surprise giant stuffed animal? Just sitting there looking at you. Oh, gosh. So what we ended up doing, coming up with no leads, we don't know anyone in New York to give it to. On the final day, as we're checking out of the hotel, we go down to the lobby, and I've got Shrek in my arms, and I go over to the bellhop or the door guy or whatever, New York, and I say to him, do you have a kid? He says, yeah, I got a kid. And cool, this is for you, this is for your kid, enjoy. And he said thank you, which is really nice of him, because if someone had given me a giant Shrek doll, I probably wouldn't have said thank you, I would have said a different word. But he said thank you, and I've always kind of wondered what happened after that point, because, I don't know. Did he get rid of it? Is it just now being passed around New York from house to house, like a really weird game at Pass the Parcel? Or maybe his kids loved it. Who knows? I don't know. Maybe they love Shrek. Maybe to them that's the day they received the Shrek doll from the incredibly nice random stranger lady. Or maybe not. Maybe you just pitched it, which we probably should have done, but it felt wasteful, you know? So, I wanted to tell you guys that story first out of all the stories, because it's the first story. It's not the first story chronologically. I have earlier ones, and I'll probably tell you some of them at some point. But it's the first story because when I was a little kid, I wanted to be a storyteller. More than a lot of things, not more than anything, but I wanted it a lot. And I would go to the library, the school library, and sometimes the library, and I would go over to, I don't even remember what it is anymore, but I used to have it memorized even, the Dewey Decimal Number for Myths and Legends, and I would go there and I would just read everything they had, in an effort to memorize all those stories, so I would have stories to tell people. I would have stories for the happy times, for the sad times, stories for advice, stories with messages, and I always wanted to have the right story for the situation. And I read all those stories, but I felt it wasn't enough to have stories out of a book like that, because the reason they're myths and legends is because everyone knows them and everyone has heard them. So I wanted so badly to have my own stories to tell. And I've never really had that exciting a life. It's been a stressful life at times, but exciting, not so much. And I never thought that I would really have that. But I've told this Shrek doll story so many times over the years. 2004 to 2021, that's got to be 16 years? Help me out, I'm bad at math. It's probably 17 or something. Maybe it's 15. Anyway, I've told that story so many times over the years, and it was the first story that made me realize that I did have stories of myself, of my own self to tell. I did have things that I could tell other people about, and I could make them laugh, and I could hopefully make them think a little too, or maybe even stop thinking when you need to get your mind off something. So, yeah. Over the next couple weeks, I'm going to try and post some more stories and see if we can't get a bit of a thing going here. Please bear with me as I learn how to use all this video equipment. Next step is I'm going to see if I can get this green screen to work a little better so I don't sparkle the whole time like I'm some sort of Twilight vampire or something. So thank you. And thank you for listening to my story.